Hello YouTube, how's everyone doing? It's Professional here. Welcome back to my playthrough of Destroy All Humans 2 Reprobed Edition. Hope you guys are enjoying this series. Sorry for the delay, haven't had a part out in a few days, but we're continuing from where we left off here, so we're gonna go fight Godzilla now.
Hey, Poxy. Finally kicked you out of the geisha house, huh?
Ask about the monster.
Did you figure out where that ginormous monster went?
Not for certain, but I'm picking up a signal in the ocean to the south.
Yeah? What kind of signal?
A radiation signature, emanating in gamma waves from the creature's tortured brain.
Tortured?
Yes. It's as if the monster is crying out, "Kill me! Kill me!"
That's gotta be the most pathetic thing I've ever heard.
Do you want me to kill it? How did they make that thing anyway?
Look, Pox, explain this monster to me. The Ivans can't even make a decent wristwatch. How the hell they come up with the technology to turn a summer intern into that?
I've been trying to figure that one out myself, and I keep coming to the same conclusion. They didn't.
What are you suggesting?
I'm not sure, but there's more than good old-fashioned Russian can-do spirit at work here.
You're telling me those people have all the initiative of a normal convention.
So that's actually a reference to From Russia with Love, James Bond movie. And in that movie, it's when James Bond actually goes to the Soviet embassy and asks them about the time. And then the guy actually says Soviet clocks always work, so that's what Crypto's kind of making fun of when he says that Russian wristwatches don't even work.
So you want me to hunt down this monstrosity and put it out of its misery?
Actually, I want you to read its mind and intuit the source of its cognitive dissonance, so we can get it some help and over time teach it confidence and self-esteem.
You gotta be kidding me.
Of course I am, you mutation! Now go kill that thing!
Recap mission goals.
So I just fly over the ocean, look for bubbles, and follow them around.
Until the monster comes up for air, yes. And then you frack it!
I love it when you talk Cylon.
Accept mission.
Okay. But how do I find it?
Do I have to? You get in your saucer and fly to the spot marked on your radar. Look for bubbles on the water. That's a pretty good sign there's a monster!
So then what? I just drop some fat boys into the water and blow it up?
Unfortunately, no. Your saucer's weapons are ineffective underwater. You'll have to figure out some way to get the beast to surface first.
And then I play a little whack-a-lizard. Got it.
So yeah, this is gonna be a Godzilla saucer boss battle. One of the most memorable moments in the game. Okay, let's enter the...
Alright, Crypto, follow that bubble trail!
One bubble bloodbath coming up.
Whoa. What are these things in the air? Yeah, this part I don't remember too well. I do remember when it surfaces, you gotta fight it.
Sure. Fasten your seatbelts. It's gonna be a bumpy ride.
Thank you. I don't know what Pox was doing fishing over there.
Don't crush me! Don't crush me! Oh, brains! My lives are flashing before my eyes! Kill it, Crypto! Kill it!
Avoid critical overcharge level.
Apparently, her destructive prowess is linked to her ability to regenerate.
Okay, so I see. I think.
Giant lizard lady gets to grow a new femur when she destroys things, but Crypto has to drain energy from vehicles like a sissy. Okay.
Damn these. Damn, man, these AAs are just ridiculous. So, I forgot how difficult this mission is. So, when you're fighting, you're fighting Godzilla, and then you're trying to, avoid all the AAs at the same time. Oh, yeah, I might just have to go over the military base and just destroy it really quickly first.
Arcoodle, damn it. What's the deal here, Pox? The more stuff that thing knocks down, the more it regenerates.
Then kill it faster!
You kill it faster. Every time I knock it to the canvas, it just comes back bigger and better than ever.
Well, it has to have a weakness somewhere. Find it and hit it hard. You don't want to lose the big one in front of the ninja group. The health is regenerating too quickly. You'll need to attack faster, Crypto.
I don't give a damn about my little ninja groupies. I'm worried about getting my ass off!
Giant monster.
Whoa, try to regenerate my health too. Okay, try to destroy this before. Okay, I guess gotta get up there and then destroy this building before Godzilla destroys it or Kojira. I didn't make it on critical overcharge level, or whatever. Oh, I think I'm hurting it now. My health back. I forgot how difficult this mission is.
I
all these AAs. Okay, there we go. Got some more Sonic Boom. Land somewhere here now. Aw, man. Yeah, these AAs are just getting really annoying. At least the military's helping me. Meteor strikes do some damage to it. Need to regenerate some ammo here. Okay, perfect. Spawn a gastro gun too, okay. Whoa. Damn, gotta get into some cover here. Okay, here's my health coming back. Okay, almost got the boss. There we go. Okay, yeah, that's the end of the battle.
The same. Toya! What have you done to that poor girl?
For once, it's not what it looks like.
I don't even know what it looks like. Never mind, we don't have time. Now, I just received word from Sergei, my contact at the KGB. He says they're building Project Solaris at a Soviet base in Siberia. The town is called Tunguska. It's a little remote.
No kidding, because I thought everything in Russia was 20 minutes from everything else. Tick-tock, dollface.
So yeah, she was messed up by the Blisk spores in the previous part. That's why she became that big monster. Wonder what the newspaper is gonna say about this. Popular mascots. Mount Seiyuku's out, Kojira's in. Build your own Kojira costume in 10 simple steps. So, oh, we're on top of this. About the tower here, guys, there's a little bit of a funny Easter egg at the very top of the tower. Little hard to get to the top, like, requires a lot of precision. Ah, yeah, see? This is what I mean. No. Yeah, you mess one up and then you fall all the way to the very bottom. No. Now you... Yeah, this is exactly what happens, is you miss one, and then you gotta try going all the way up again. No, I'm not falling again here. So this is the very top here, and this is the little Easter egg that you got. You got this duck, floating duck. That's it. You cannot actually get up any higher. If you try to get to the very top, though, it's like an uneven surface, so you can't really get up there. Tunguska is like a pretty foggy and creepy place in the original, so I wonder what the remake is doing it like. Back in the USSR.
So this is Tunguska. Yikes.
It's good to be back in the USSR, but this place makes the rest of Siberia look tropical.
Complain about Tunguska. Make small talk.
Looking good, Goldie. That outfit could melt an iceberg.
Thanks. You're welcome to borrow it sometime if you like.
Complain about Tunguska.
Yeah, a little nippy. I better incinerate something for heat before my tool falls off.
Can't have that. But I think we can arrange an opportunity for creative combustion. We need to gather intelligence on Project Solaris. Want to help me out?
Agree to help?
You know it, sugar. What do you need me to do?
I'm not sure yet. I'll know more after Agent Sergei briefs me.
Sergei? Ah. Not him again.
Yes, him again. He's been here for weeks, digging up intel on Project Solaris.
Yeah, he's a regular 007 off. What's he got that I ain't got?
Hair, for one thing. Here he comes. Let me do the talking.
So Crypto really doesn't like Sergei because Sergei is Natalia's boyfriend also.
The Ukraine girls knock me out.
Moscow girls make me shout. It's good to see you, Sergei.
Natalyushka, you look devastating, as usual.
I know, but we have no time for further verbal foreplay. What can you tell me of Project Solaris?
Not as much as I'd like. There is a classified area nearby, obscured day and night by a cloud of radioactive gas. I believe it is the source of the insidious organic weapons being used to subjugate.
Svologi.
Duh. The area plans are kept in a high-security section of KGB headquarters.
Can you sneak us in?
You and your little Zaitchik? I don't see how. Now, if it were just the two of us...
Jealousy, Sergei?
Though the fire fades, comrade, the embers may yet smolder. Even in the tundra.
Thank you, comrade. We'll find our own way in. Now go. You mustn't be seen with me.
So, exactly what kind of history do you have with this Sergei guy?
Exactly the kind you think, Crypto. Not that it's any of your business.
Hey, see whoever you want. You can bang the Red Army chorus for all I care.
Your permission is noted. Now can we get to work?
Ask about the mission. Insult Sergei.
Sergei. Who does he think he is? Omar Sharif? I mean, look at the guy. What does he bench? 80, 85 tops?
He wrestles bears.
He wrestles bears. Ask about the mission.
Okay, so how do we get our hands on the plans?
Sergei says we'll have to sneak into the KGB headquarters and steal them.
Oh, Sergei says that, does he?
He does. The odds will be against us. The place is swarming with agents.
Offer to fight KGB.
Well, Crypto says bring them on. The more the freaking merrier.
Okay, then. Actually, you might be onto something there, Crypto. If you can create a large enough disturbance, it might lure most of the agents out of the building.
And while I'm playing monkey ball, you'll sneak in and grab the plans. Gotcha.
Recap mission goals.
Okay, run this plan by me one more time, would you?
Pay attention, Crypto. It slows us down if I have to tell you everything twice. Maybe I should go ask Sergei to create the diversion.
Wait. I think it's... It's all coming back to me. I have to create a diversion to lure the KGB agents out of their HQ. Here's an idea. I just start blowing stuff up, and then the KGB will come out and see what all the commotion is.
Brilliant.
Start mission.
Okay, Dollface, I'm off to stir up the Soviets. Be careful in there. You hear me?
Don't worry, Crypto. You keep them occupied, and I'll be just fine. Whatever you do, just keep them away from the HQ building. Good luck.
So now here's the, kill people with radioactive mist. Okay. Now, about Tunguska, so like I said, this is the only real name place, because every single other place in this game is based on, like, a fictional Tokyo, fictional San Francisco, but this is actually a real place. It's actually called Tunguska, and so, The thing about Tunguska is, like, a lot of people, like, you know, when they think of aliens, you know, they think of, like, stuff like Roswell, they think of, like, Area 51, but the thing is, nobody really thinks of Tunguska, which Tunguska is, like, Russia's version of Roswell. And so a lot of people don't think that, what if the Soviets, you know, encountered aliens and stuff like that? I'm not into the whole conspiracy thing, I don't believe that. But what I'm saying is, not a lot of people think about that, that maybe the Soviets had some contact with aliens. And so that's actually what a huge plot this game is actually based on. Destroy property to attract KGB attention, okay. So, basically, oh, and this is the Red Army that you fight here also. But, about Tunguska is, like, 10 years before World War One, I think it was like a few years before World War One. There was like a huge meteor that actually hit Russia. Now at the time, it was the Russian Empire, it wasn't the Soviet Union yet. And there's a lot of conspiracies that it wasn't actually a meteor, but an alien ship. And the reason people think that way is because the where the meteor crashed, it was actually not too far from a major body of water. And so a lot of people thought that the aliens were trying to go there to see if they could find other life. But yeah, this is in Siberia, and so Siberia is one of the coldest places in the world, but this is actually southern Siberia, which is not as bad as northern Siberia. Northern Siberia is the worst place. But Siberia is like, you know, terrain similar to this. It has like, you know, some forests, but it also, like, the coldest parts of Siberia are the tundra, where basically you have like these fields with like no trees. Siberia is actually the vast majority of like Russia's land, but it's not most of the land is not inhabitable. Like, people could live there, but it's a very difficult life just because of the climate. KGB base, safe house. Sergei's grandma's house? What? Okay. Man, this game is funny. Use extract brain on Natalia's attackers. Okay. Down. But yeah, the Tunguska is actually the place that I was looking forward to seeing the most in this game. Oh great, yeah, get a little hurt here. Okay, just gotta do it on one more here. There we go.
Don't let her get away!
Okay, gotta get to Sergei's grandma's house. But, Siberia is also the location where the vast majority of the Gulag system was, which the Russian Empire and the Soviet Union ran, which were forced labor camps. And Stalin had hundreds of these camps, like, across, like, the Soviet Union. They were very bad. You got sent to one of those Gulags, you had a very little chance of actually surviving.
Not bad, huh? If there's one thing I can do, it's make with the boom boom.
ask about the plans Italia stole, make small talk.
Admit it, Goldie. I'm your knight in a shining spacesuit, and you just can't resist me.
I'm resisting you right now, Crypto. And you're wearing Mylar pajamas.
Damn.
Ask about the plans
so
Natalia stole.
So how about those plans, you swine? They the real deal or what?
I just had time to glance at them quickly before the alarms went off. There seemed to be a number of tunnels and a lot of security around them. And it looks like the tunnels have these bizarre organic pumps inside, which are what's pumping the radioactive gas over the area.
Ask what you should do.
So I take it we're gonna put these organic pumps out of business.
Da, but a direct assault would be dangerous. I need to talk to some people. Lay low for a while, tovarish. I'll be back soon.
Why do they always ask me to do the one thing I suck at?
Yeah, Crypto is impatient. He cannot wait. Back in the USSR. You know, speaking of which, for what reason half Natalia returned? Loshi comes with the son of Arkvoodle, favorite daughter of the sacred crotch. And these buildings are pretty also, you know, the developers did their research also. These buildings are pretty accurate to what a lot of cabins and, like, wooden buildings actually look like in, Russia and Siberia. I guess we'll wrap it up here. Maybe I'll do a lore video on, like, Tunguska one day and compare it to this game. But, just look it up. Go on Google and type in Tunguska Russian alien conspiracies and you'll see a lot about it. A lot of people don't know about it. Everybody knows about Roswell and Area 51, but a lot of people don't know about the Tunguska incident. I hope that you guys enjoyed this. Thank you guys for watching. I hope that you guys had a lot of fun. I'll see you in the next one. Take care, everyone. Have a wonderful day, guys.